And our word for today on this memorial of St. Stanislaus, Bishop and Martyr, on this Thursday, April the 11th, our word for today is ration. Ration, our word for today, and here to talk about it, as he is with us each Thursday, it's Andrew Reinhart. Good morning, Andrew.
Good morning, Dave and Ron. How are you?
Doing great. Pretty How are you?
I'm doing great. Yeah. A little bit rainy out there today, but I feel the sunshine inside a little bit, so we're doing
good.
Oh,
there you go.
We're just glad the eclipse isn't today.
Yeah, the eclipse. The world didn't end. I'm happy we're still here. Or I'm not happy we're still here.
We're glad for that.
But it's a new heaven and new earth, right? So even if the world ended, we'd still be here, right?
Amen.
Maybe we'd still be doing the radio and we'd just all be better off. But our word of the day is ration. Or this is, I think, a really interesting term that is used here. I didn't look up the original Greek under here, but the word ration in Latin would be coming from the word ratio, right? Reason. And the idea here is that it's sort of the reasonable amount to, let's say, eat or to portion out, right? So if you have a very limited amount, for example, like you're in the military and you're off posted somewhere in a foreign country, you have a certain amount of rations. Or if you're, you know, in a situation where food isn't available, you're going to ration out the food that you have. But the basic idea here is that when you have something that's a limited amount, that there's a certain amount, a fixed amount, and maybe you can't get more, or getting more is very difficult, it is reasonable to only eat a little bit at a time to make it last, so to speak. So when Jesus is talking here, he says that the Father, and really kind of opening up to us, does not ration his gift of the Spirit. He does not ration his gift of the Spirit. How can this make sense? It only makes sense, right, if the Spirit is God, if the Spirit is unlimited, if the Spirit is infinite. And in light of that, right, this is what makes it make sense. The Father loves the Son and has given everything over to him, has given everything over to him. Right? How can you give everything over to someone? Because you realize, right, that you're not going to be without even if you give everything. Right? This is kind of that dynamic of love, that even as the world gets darker and more sinful, there's these dynamics, especially in the family, that continue to reveal God's nature, right? Fatherhood and motherhood can even make a wicked person into a good person, is how they treat their own children, right? Right? So there's a way that these natural designs, right, make us imitate the Lord. But of course, we live in a world of which Christianity is getting dimmer, right? Christendom is sort of fading in our world, and we're in a new time where now people that don't go to church are more common than people that do, right? And there's a lot of modern ideas that have come out of this world where Christianity has been removed. It's important to realize that modernism, our modern world, is really, it's really a Christian heresy. You know, the world we have today grew out of Christendom and is only possible because of Christendom. And the presumptions and the assumptions and the worldview that we have in what's sometimes called the collective West is a result of Christianity, but it's a parasite on Christianity. You know, so these ideas we have, like, for example, the idea of progress, that progress is always good, right? Well, this is a Christian idea. We're headed toward the kingdom of God. And so this idea that history is headed toward some kind of good end, that's Christianity. That's where they got that idea. And in the classic world, there's either a cyclical idea of the world, or the idea was things were sort of good at the beginning and have gotten worse since then. So this idea of progress is really a Christian heresy. Early philosophers who start to cope with a world without God, you know, they really went to these extremes. There were philosophers like Hobbes that talked about people being evil and scared and brutish in their natural state. And the idea was that society civilized people, right? Civilization, it civilized people and made them good. So in the natural state, humanity was bad, and society makes them good. And so, you know, we even have this in our language. We call native peoples without the kind of civilization we had, they called them savages, right? And on the opposite end, you had romantics like Rousseau, who said that at base, people were good, and it's society that corrupted people. And so this is where our image of what the image of the noble savage, right? These characters like Tarzan that are within our society, where it's society that's corrupted people, and there's this basic nobility to humanity before they enter civilization. Right, so our modern world has these two extremes, and really a lot of these philosophies are at the base of our two extreme political positions today too. But in the Christian view, we had this idea of the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God, and Augustine compares that with the kingdom of earth. The kingdom of earth, although in God's original design was good, was corrupted because of sin. And it's because of God's intervention, God's redemption, our salvation, that we have this kingdom of God. And so living in this perspective, where we can actually do things that aren't in our self-interest for the good of others, agape love, that sacrificial love, that's a result of Christian grace. Without Christianity, without the cross, without the church, our society does not function. And as we continue to get further from God, what you're going to find is further and further dysfunction until the systems that we rely on in our society will no longer work. Right? We'll enter another period of totalitarianism in the world. And we see this in societies where Christianity either never was or is already gone. Right? So the world we live in only makes sense in light of the gospel. And in that context, we can really give freely. So we can transform the world by giving as God gives. So our word for the day is ration.
Love it. Thank you, Andrew. My goodness.
A lot to think about there, yeah.
Hi, everybody. This is Dr. Ray, host of The Doctor Is In. You are listening to Annunciation Radio, Catholic radio for the Diocese of Toledo. Faith with frequency.